Hi viewers, welcome to Shekhar's Bio Factory for NEET. If you like this video, subscribe my channel and click on bell icon to get notifications. In this video, I am going to explain the structure and types of stomata. Stomata is the main structure. It is associated with transpiration and exchange of gases during photosynthesis and respiration. And these stomata are located on the surface of leaf, and these stomata, when it is open and closed, it facilitate both transpiration and exchange of gases. So to understand the mechanism of closing and opening of stomata, first we have to know the structure of stomata. In this, when we observe the stomatal apparatus. So stomatal apparatus means the structures which are associated with stomata, these are called as stomatal apparatus. In this stomatal apparatus, So on the surface of leaf, it consists of stomatal apparatus. In this stomatal apparatus, we can observe different parts like a minute pore is present, and this minute pore, it is surrounded by a specialized epidermal cells. These are called as God cells. And again, these God cells are surrounded by some of the epidermal cells. These are called as subsidiary cells. These are also called as accessory cells. And below to this minute pore, it consists of a cavity. Now it is called substomatal cavity. So in this way, the stomatal apparatus, it consists of a minute pore, and this minute pore is surrounded by God cells, and these God cells are surrounded by subsidiary cells or accessory cells, and this pore, it consists of a cavity. It is called substomatal cavity. The minute pore present on the surface of leaf, and this minute pore, it is the main site for exchange of gases and transpiration. This minute pore present on the surface of leaf, it is surrounded by two specialized cells, and these specialized cells are called as God cells. And these God cells having different shapes. In case of dicotyledon plants, in dicots, the shape of this God cell is either a bean shape or kidney shape. In similar way, the monocotyledon leaf, in monocots, the shape of this God cell is dumbbell shape. So the dicotyledons having God cells with bean shape or kidney shape, the monocots having these God cells with dumbbell shape. So these God cells having a specialized cell structure. In the structure of every God cell, the God cell, it is surrounded by a cell wall. This cell wall having unequal thickness, because the cell wall present towards pore. This cell wall, it is very thick and elastic in nature, but the cell wall present, the remaining portion, it is a thin and non-elastic in nature. So because of thick and elastic cell wall present towards pore, it facilitate the opening and closing of stomata. So the pore portion having thick and elastic cell wall, and the remaining portion, of a cell wall, it is thin. It is a cell wall nature of God cells. And inside of this God cell, these God cells, it consists of a protoplasm, and in this protoplasm, one large vacuole is present, and this vacuole, it helps to opening and closing of stomata by maintaining osmotic pressure. So it is called as vacuoles. So the vacuole, so present in God cells, it maintain osmotic pressure. And along with this vacuole, the very most important structures in protoplasm, and these protoplasm, it consists of chloroplast. That is a chloroplast, and this chloroplast, it associated with photosynthesis. Along with vacuole, it consists of chloroplast, and it perform photosynthesis. So in the structure of this God cell, some of the cellulose microfibrils, these cellulose microfibrils are present transversely in the structure of each cell wall, and these cellulosic microfibrils and its orientation, it facilitates the opening and closing of stomata during transpiration and gases exchange. And along with this cell wall, it consists of a specialized structure. These specialized structures are present in their cell wall. These are called as hydrogen and potassium pumps. These are very most important structures associated with the closing and opening of stomata. These are called as hydrogen and potassium pumps. These hydrogen and potassium pumps present in the cell wall of God cell, it helps to transport potassium ions and K plus ions by utilizing ATP energy actively. So that is the structure of God cells, and these God cells having either bean or kidney shape in dicots and dumbbell shape in monocots. Along with this, these God cells are surrounded by some of the epidermal cells, and these epidermal cells are called as subsidiary cells or accessory cells. These are subsidiary cells. So the main function of this subsidiary cell is, these subsidiary cells having water, and with the help of this water, based on concentration gradient, water can transport from subsidiary cells to God cells, God cells to subsidiary cells during stomata opening and closing. And the very most important thing, these subsidiary cells, the subsidiary cells are non-chlorophyllous in nature. These are non-chlorophyllous in nature due to absence of chloroplast. So along with this, just below to this pore, it consists of a cavity. It is called as a substomatal cavity. It helps to exchange of gases during opening and closing of stomata. So these are the structures associated with stomatal operators. Stomata is a main site for transpiration and gas exchange. And the number of stomata are vary from one leaf to another leaf, especially in dicotyledon leaf. The dicotyledon leaf having dorsiventral leaf. In this dorsiventral leaf, more number of stomata are present in lower surface. It is called as abaxial surface compared to adaxial or upper surface. But in case of isobilateral leaf, in isobilateral leaf or in monocot leaf, the number of stomata are equal in both the adaxial and abaxial epidermis. At the same time, in majority of the plants, the stomata, it is open during daytime and closed during nighttime. Such type of stomata are called as photoactive stomata. So in majority of plants, we can observe photoactive stomata. So photoactive stomata means they are open at a daytime and close at night. But in few plants, like succulent plants, in this plant, it consists of scotoactive stomata. So scotoactive stomata means in these plants, the stomata are open during nighttime and closed during daytime. These are called as scotoactive stomata. And along with this, in xerophytic plants, the stomata are present at lower surface, especially in a cavity. These are called as sunken stomata. So sunken stomata, so these sunken stomata are present in case of xerophytes. But in hydrophytes, the stomata, especially some of the hydrophytic plants which having floating leaves, in these plants, the stomata are present on upper surface only, but at lower surface, there is no stomata. In this way, we can observe the structure of stomata and the types of stomata based on different characters in different plants.